Hi everyone, I'm Iveta. Today I'm here to explain to you everything about proxy rotation, why it's important, and show you a tutorial on how to rotate proxies with Python. Let's get started. Simply put, proxy rotation is a process that assigns different IP addresses to a new session based on a specific time frame, status code, or a number of requests. There are many ways to rotate proxies. First of all, you can change the proxies used by manually configuring the proxy server settings in the browser. Various proxy manager tools can also be of great help to set up and easily change proxies. Alternatively, you can use an automated proxy rotator tool, such as Oxylabs Proxy Rotator. This tool will automatically rotate the proxy IP address using the random IP rotation method. Another way is to execute proxy rotation with Python. We'll show you a step-by-step tutorial later in this video. First and foremost, proxy rotation enhances the level of anonymity. Secondly, when it comes to web scraping operations, a common challenge faced by many is avoiding getting blocked by websites while trying to gather public data. Several techniques can aid the prevention of blocks, one of which is proxy rotation. It can help operate scrapers past most anti-scraping measures, as it allows you to imitate the behavior of multiple users, hence strengthening the chance of being undetected while gathering vast amounts of public data. Proxy rotation makes it easy to gather public data for various purposes that include but are not limited to price aggregation, SEO monitoring, travel aggregation, competitive analysis, market research. Also, rotating proxies can be helpful for testing purposes such as checking your server's capability. With the help of proxy rotation, you can create a stable flow of requests to simulate specific activity such as a sudden spike in traffic. Now you know why proxy rotation is important for web scraping and other use cases. Let's shift our focus to rotating proxies with Python. You should start by creating a virtual environment. You should do that by running this command. This will install Python, pip, and common libraries in your VNV folder. Next, you need to invoke the source command to activate the environment. The last step is to install the requests module in the current virtual environment. And that's it, you have successfully installed the requests module. Before we delve deeper into how to rotate proxies with Python, we could find out your current IP address. You need to create a file with the .p extension and provide the script shown in this video. Now you should run it from a terminal. The output will show your current IP address. Our goal is to show you how to hide your IP address and rotate different IPs to stay anonymous and avoid getting blocked, so let's move forward. Now let's start from the basics, how to use a single proxy. First of all, you need to find and choose proxies. You can always use free proxies, but we have to mention that most of the time they're unreliable, slow, and unstable. There are various trustworthy proxy providers to choose from, with Oxylabs included. In order to use a proxy server, you will need scheme, example HTTP, IP address, port, example 3128, username and password to connect to the proxy, but it's optional. Once you have all the information, you need to set it up in this folder. Here are a few examples of the proxy formats you may encounter. Once you have the proxy information, assign it to a constant. Next, define a timeout in seconds, as it is always a good idea to avoid waiting indefinitely for the response that may never be returned due to network issues, server issues, or the problems with the proxy server. The requests module needs to know when to actually use the proxy. You should consider the website you are attempting to access. Does it use HTTP or HTTPS protocols? Since we are trying to access HTTPS ip.oxlabs.io/ip, we can define this configuration as follows. Note that you can specify multiple protocols and even define specific domains for which a different proxy will be used. Finally, you should try to make a request by calling requests.get and passing all the variables we defined earlier. With our script, we can also handle the exceptions and show the error when the network issue occurs. The output of the script should show you the IP of your proxy. You are now hidden behind the proxy when making your request through the Python script. Now we can move on to learning how to rotate a list of proxies instead of using a single one. Most proxy providers, such as Oxylabs, allow downloading a list of proxies in a CSV or similar format. This list can be used to implement proxy rotation. In this tutorial, we're going to use a list of proxies in a CSV file called proxies.csv. First of all, create Python file and define both the file name and how long are you willing to wait for a single proxy to respond. Next, write the code that opens the CSV file and reads every proxy server line by line into a CSV row variable and puts scheme proxy map configuration needed by the request module. To check if everything is working, we will use the same scraping code as before to access the website via proxies. If you want to scrape the publicly available content using any working proxy from the list, add a break after print to stop going through the proxies in the CSV file. And that's it. The only thing preventing us from reaching our full potential is speed. Of course, we have a solution for this issue as well. Checking all the proxies in the list one by one may be an option for some, but it has one significant downside. This approach is painfully slow. This is because we are using a synchronous approach. We tackle requests one at a time and only move to the next once the previous one is completed. A better option would be to make requests and wait for responses in a non-blocking way. This would speed up the script significantly. In order to do that, you should use the AIO HTTP module. You can install it using the following CLI command. Then you need to create a Python file where you define the CSV file name that contains the proxy list, URL that you wish to use to check the proxies, how long you are willing to wait for each proxy, the timeout setting. Next, you need to define an async function and run it to the asyncio module. It accepts two parameters, the URL it needs to request, the proxy to use to access it. Then you need to print the response. If the script received an error when attempting to access the URL via proxy, it will print it as well. The next step is to define a main function that reads the CSV file and creates an asynchronous task to check the proxy for every single record in the CSV file. You should run the main function and wait until the async tasks are complete. Your code for proxy rotation now runs exceptionally fast. I hope this video has helped you understand why proxy rotation is important and how to rotate your proxies with Python. Thanks for watching! If you have any questions about proxies or any other specific topic, drop us a line at hello@oxylabs.io or write a comment below. Also, if you find this content beneficial, press the like button and share it on social media. Check out these videos on web scraping and everything related to it.